bulkhead anchors, as we have finished last class about the fixed arch support, let us solve one example. Anchor is there, means seat pile is there, then it has been decided to provide this anchor rod, say at a distance 1 meter, and the soil profile is saying below 2 meter the anchor rod. This is the anchor rod. Below 2 meter of anchor rod, there is a water table. This is the symbol of water table, and gamma above water table is 18 kilonewton per meter cube, and phi is equal to, for both the cases, phi is equal to 30 degree. Gamma saturated is equal to 20 kilonewton per meter cube, that is below the water table, and this height is 3 meter. Now, it has been asked by means of fixed arch support method, find the embedded depth D. By fixed arch support, find the D, and anchor rod capacity also FA. As we have discussed, it can be solved by means of elastic line or by means of equivalent beam method. We will see now for the equivalent beam method how we can solve it. For the case of equivalent beam method, as I said earlier, the steps, first principle is to find it out your K, Kp, all other parameters. So, from whatever the value of phi is given, from there Ka is equal to 1/3, as it is 30 degree, Kp is equal to 3, and K dash is equal to 3 minus 1 by 3, which is equal to 2.67. Now, next step, once you find it out K, Kp and K dash, draw the pressure distribution diagram, then find it out what is your pressure. If I take it into two parts by means of, I am solving this example by means of beam method, equivalent beam method, that means taking this and I am drawing this pressure distribution diagram. Now, here is your water table, here is your anchor rod. Now, this is the water table, and from there it is coming, because at certain distance, if I draw, give an idea how the pressure distribution diagram it is, I am just drawing here in this question paper, I am just drawing how it comes in a way like this. And this part, if you remember well, this part has been, as it is a fixed arch method, there will not be any deflection. So, this part will be replaced by an equivalent load. So, if you make it by means of a particularly equivalent beam method, you assume up to this, where it is 0, up to this point of contraflexure. Say point of contraflexure is at a distance x, up to these you consider as one part, and below these you consider as a one part. I am just reviewing what we have done in the last class for solving this problem. Now, I have taken into consideration particularly here, if you take it, this is my point of contraflexure. So, upper part from here it has been considered as a one unit and bottom part as one unit. So, as assumption is that it is a hinge support for equivalent beam method. With this hinge support there are two forces opposite acting to each other, so that net force will be 0. So, once I draw this, so this is a height 1 meter, this is your height 2 meter. Now, find it out pressure distribution diagram. From there you can find it out what is the value of pressure. It will be 28.19, then this is your 15.2. If I name it A, B and J, and here if I draw, take into consideration of the bottom part, then this is 15.2 and this will be your 27.1, and this is your R p, and this is your somewhere else you can write it down, this is your R b. Then this distance, as I said, this distance is your x and this distance is your a minus x. Then from here to here this distance is y minus a, which is equal to nothing but I have taken capital A, and from here to here this distance is y minus x. Now, we will solve this step by step. Now, let me calculate value of, as you said, this is the pressure distribution diagram and this part will take at a 1 unit, this is as a 1 unit by equivalent beam. So, here you can find it out what is the pressure distribution at step by step, we can find it out, we can calculate, then see whether these values are coming, whatever I have written, whether these values are coming ok or not. Then let us start with the top part. Top part distance is your say 1 meter. If you look at here, from here to here distance is 1 meter and here to here distance is 3 meter and here to here distance is 3 plus 2 plus 1, this is your 6 meter. So, now P A dash is equal to 1/3 into 3 into 18 plus 1/3 into 3 into 20 minus 9.81. How it has come this P A dash? This P A dash, it has come if you divide into small parts, this is your this part, or you can take it as a whole, your K A is equal to 1/3. So, K A is equal to 1/3. 1/3 into 3 means this is your K A, this is your H, this is your gamma, this is your gamma. If you look at here, this will be your entire this. So, now as I said, K A is your 1/3, this is your 3 and gamma is equal to 18, and for this part this is your K A, this is your H, this is your gamma submerged. Gamma submerged is nothing but gamma saturated minus gamma W. Gamma saturated weight is given 20 kilonewton per meter cube, and gamma w is nothing but your weight of water, unit weight of water. So 20 minus 9.81. How the concept has come? 20 minus 9.81. This is the pressure at the base. So it is coming 28.18 kilonewton per meter square. Now next step is, this is your step 1, you find it out pressure at the dredge line. Next step is find it out distance A. So A is equal to P A prime divided by gamma prime K prime. So from there, which is equal to 28.18 divided by 10.19 into 2.67 is your K prime, from where we have calculated this is your 2.67, and this is coming about 1.04 meter. Now then you find it out from the chart. If you remember well, I have given a chart last class. From there you can find it out x. As you know, for phi is equal to 30 degree, x is equal to, from the chart, x is equal to 0.08 h. This is from the chart, from where x is coming about 0.48 meter. That means distance below the dredge line at which you are getting point of contraflexure, that means bending moment is equal to 0, that distance we are getting from the chart for phi is equal to 30 degree is about 0.48 meter. Now once you get this one, then you can find it out what is your P prime. This is your P prime. So P prime is equal to A minus x by A into P A dash, which is equal to 1.04 minus 0.48, then 28.19 by 1.04, which is equal to 15.2 kilonewton per meter square. This is the value I have written from the pressure distribution diagram. If you look at here, this is 18 kilonewton per meter square, this is 28.19 kilonewton per meter square, and this is your 15.2 kilonewton per meter square. Then once you get P A, P prime, then A, your next step is going towards your taking. What is your next step? We'll have to find it out RB. From this pressure distribution diagram, we know all these value. What is the other value is missing? The other value is missing your, that means we have to find it out RB, force RB. This force RB will come from your equilibrium conditions. What is that condition? This condition is movement about anchor rod is equal to 0. This is your assumption earlier, as I said, movement about your anchor rod is 0. Now taking movement is equal to 0 of the entire free body diagram about the anchor rod, is equal to 0. From there you can find it out half 18 into 3 into 1 plus 18 into 3 into 3.5 plus half into 10.19 into 3 into 4, then plus 15.2 into 0.48 into 5.24 then plus half 12.99 into 0.48 into 5.16 minus RB prime into 5.48. Let us start with this step by step how I have taken the moment. Half 18.3 into 1. If you look at here, this triangle, if you look at here, half, this is your area where the force is coming, and it will be acted upon at a distance 1 below this from the moment. So, this is your area into 1, then 18 into 3 into 3.5. If I look at the first case, if I write it 1, this is your 2, this is your 3, this is your 4, this is your 5, and this is your 6. One part is your moment about anchor rod 1. Now go back to second part, 18 into 3 into 3.5. If I take it into two parts, this is your 18, this distance is your 3. This is your area, and it has been acted upon at the CG. This CG will be 1.5, and 1.5 plus 2, this is your 3.5. So, this part is your 2. Then come back to third. Third is your area, half pressure here into height. So, pressure is your half 10.19 into 3 into height is equal to 4. Height is equal to 4 means this is your 1 third of 3 is 1, so 2 third of the 3, this is your 2 and this is your 2. So, this distance is your 4. Then come back to fourth, this is the 4. If you take into two parts, the 15.2 into x, 15.2 into x, this is your 0.48 plus 5.24, this distance is your 3 plus 2, 5, and this is equal to 0.48 divided by 2, this is your 5 point total. If I add it, this height is your 5.24. If I am taking from the CG from here to here, this height is your 5.24 meter. Now, about fifth point, fifth part, so this is your first, second, as I have written here, this is third, this is fourth. Now, this part is your fifth. This is your, if you look at here, this part is your fifth. This part is your fifth. Now, for this fifth, what is your pressure? Half into 12.99 into 0.48 plus 5.16 is your height from the CG of that triangle to up to the anchor rod. These forces are acted upon. If you look at here, these forces are acting. These are about the anchor rod clockwise and this is your anti-clockwise. So, that is why this is negative, this is your positive. So, RB prime will act at the base. So, that means 3 plus 2, 5.48 at a distance, it is your 5.48 at a distance. And this is your part 6. Why I am solving in details? If you in the exam or if you do part by part, one by one, then chances of doing committing mistake will be less. Now, once you get it from this after solving, you can find it out, RB prime is equal to 60.5 kilonewton. Now, This is for once you get RB, this RB is equal to equal and opposite. This RB or RB prime, because this is a hinge, so there will not be any moment. So, RB prime equal and opposite force should be there. So, this RB prime once you get, then you can very easily find it out what is the distance D or in terms of y. So, let us put y minus a is equal to capital A. Now, P a prime by a, which is equal to 27.1. Now taking moment of the lower part, now taking moment is equal to 0 from here to here at the lower part, you can find it out what is your RP value in terms of A. So, take this calculation, RB dash into A plus A minus X is nothing but A value. What is the value of A? A is equal to 1.04, X is equal to what is the value of X? 0.48, 1.04 minus 0.48, this is your A minus X. So, RB prime A plus X 0.56 plus half into 15.2 into 0.56 into A plus 0.37 minus RP into A by 3, which is equal to 0. Now, once you put the value of RB dash 60.5, in this case, you can find it out RP is equal to 13.55 a square, and RB dash is equal to 60.5 kilonewton. How do I get RP? RP is coming, this is my RP, half area of the triangle, this into this, this is your A, half this and this, and it will acted upon the height. From there, RP is coming 13.55 a square, and RB dash is coming 60.5 kilonewton. So, put this value RB dash and RP here in this equation, moment equation. After putting this value, you will get an equation AQ minus 14.37 A, which is equal to 7.85. Now, by trial and error, A is coming about 4.03 meter. Now, once you get the A, then you can find it out y is equal to A plus A. A is nothing but y minus A, remember. So, from there, you can find it out 5.07 meter, and D is nothing but your 20 to 40 times more, it will be 1.2 of y, which is equal to 6.08 meter, D is equal to coming 6.08 meter. Now, once you get the value of D, then you can easily find it out what is the value of FA. FA is nothing but RA minus RB dash. So, RA is equal to what is your RA? Resultant forces of all this, total resultant forces acted here, this is your RA, minus RB, this is your FA. So, from there RA is coming about, I have not done the calculation, you can do it. RA is equal to 106.7 minus RB dash is equal to 60.5, which is equal to 46.2 kilonewton. This is all solved example, complete detailed calculation I have given in this particularly sheet pile and bulk head. Sometimes I neglect this how the calculation has been done for you, so that you can try, but one example I have solved in detail calculation. So, let me just review once again, these are all your soil parameter has been given, a sheet pile is there and there is an anchor rod. And these are all your soil parameters are there, and this is the, it has been asked to find it out embedded depth D by means of fixed earth support method, by means of fixed earth support method, and also find it out what is the force at this anchor rod. So, in this case, as I said earlier, this fixed earth support for particularly bulkhead anchors or sheet pile with anchor head. In this case, there are two methods generally we adopt, one is your by elastic line method, other is your by beam method. In beam method, at the point of contraflexure, the upper part has been acted like one beam, lower part has been acted upon by other beam. How? The assumption is that at the point of contraflexure, there will be a hinge. In the hinge, that means once you assume there is a hinge, that means moment is equal to 0. The meaning of point of contraflexure is that at that point moment is equal to 0. So, once hinge has been assumed, there will be two reaction force, each equal and opposite, so that moment is equal to 0. With this beam method, now next step is your draw the pressure distribution diagram of upper part and pressure distribution diagram of lower part. So, step 1, calculate your base from the phi, calculate K A, K P and K prime, and it has been calculated phi is equal to 30 degree. So, K A is equal to 0.33 and K P is equal to 3, K dash is equal to K P minus K A, which is equal to 3 minus 1 by 3, which is equal to 2.67. And as water table is acted below 3 meter from the ground surface. So, below the water table generally we are going to consider submerged unit weight, above the it will be your, what if the gamma value is given, it is 18 kilonewton per meter cube. So, submerged unit weight is equal to gamma saturated minus gamma W. Step 1, basic parameter you have calculated, once it is over, draw the pressure distribution diagram, and the pressure distribution diagram has been drawn. So, then step 1, find it out P A prime, pressure at this point, and P dash pressure at this point. So, instead of finding all total, what I have done it, I make it into part by part 1, 2, 3, like this part by part. From this, so P A dash is coming about 28.18 kilonewton per meter square. So, this is your 28.18 kilonewton per meter square at this point. Then once you get it, then you can find it out what is the value of A, the distance of A, where this is your distance A. So, A has to come from P A dash by gamma prime and K prime, it is equal to 1.04 meter. So, based on the value of phi, as I said earlier, by means of chart, from the chart, value of phi from the chart, x is your 0.08 h, this is coming about 0.48 meter. Once you get this is your 0.48 meter, that means point of contraflexure below the dredge line is about 0.48 meter. So, we are getting 0.48 meter value of x. Once you get the value of x, you can find it out P prime. P prime means at this level what is your pressure. So, P prime is equal to A minus x by A into P A dash. So, from there it is coming about 15.2 kilonewton per meter square, So now all the step 2, all the pressure distribution diagram is over, all the pressure distribution diagram is over. As it is an equivalent beam, consider above this, above the point of contraflexure, this as a one body, and take what is the second assumption? The movement about the anchor rod to be 0. So take movement about the anchor rod so that it will be 0. By considering movement about anchor rod, so movement has been taken into consideration. So again in this case I have taken into part by part, 1 part, 2 part, 3 part, 4 part, 5 part and 6 part. So from there the RB value, RB prime, the force coming is about 60.5 kilonewton. Once you get this force 60.5 kilonewton, this is about your 60.5 kilonewton. So these are equal and opposite. So this value also 60.5 kilonewton. So similarly you can consider movement of this second beam. This is your first assumption, one unit, one beam. This is your second beam about the base, because this is a fixed support. So from there it has been done. So it is in terms of RB dash and RP dash, RP. Then RB and RP has value has been in terms of A, and once you put, you can get the value of A. From there A is nothing but Y minus A. From there you can get it Y is equal to 5.07. From there D is coming about 20% higher, 20 to 40%. So 1.2 times of Y, it is 6.08 meter. Once D is coming, so taking an equilibrium of the upper part, R A, R B dash is coming, all forces at the base, resultant forces is your R A. So it is your R A minus R B dash. Force in the anchor rod is coming about 46.2 kilonewton. This is all about what I have discussed about seat pile wall, free support, fixed support, and seat pile wall with your anchor rod, free and fixed support, fixed earth method. And in this case there are two cases. For each case, one is your cohesionless soil, another is your cohesive soil. This is all case by case I have derived of how to get your embedded depth from the basic equation. Then each and every case we have solved one practical example, how to get D and how to get also anchor rod force. This is all about. We will start next class some other new topic. Thank you.